March 22nd, 2014, we had two vessels that collided in the Houston Ship Channel.
There was a timing issue with an incoming inbound ship and a barge and tug crossing the channel.
The crew members started reporting that they had oil leaking from the barge.
We had about 170,000 gallons of fuel that was spilled into the ship channel.
Any large spill like this, we get notified by the Coast Guard or the General Land Office to come and assist in it as a role of a natural resource advisor.
Since it was a large event, we did pull people from Austin, from Corpus, even down from Brownsville. We had folks coming in to help us.
Okay. We coordinated, figured out what we need, got the materials together, and got down to the coast as soon as we could.
We all came from different offices, but we were able to coordinate and work effectively together, as well as the different federal agencies that were at the incident command.
One of the challenges was quickly finding areas that needed the highest priority protection.
The time of year, we were starting to get a lot of migration coming through. A lot of our shorebirds were on the beaches utilizing them for feeding. So that was a big challenge.
As the oil traveled down the Houston Ship Channel, it went out into the Gulf.
The trajectory was for the spill to actually hit the southern portion of Matagorda Island.
Logistically speaking, it was very difficult to get to the island.
You need a boat in order to access it. And then once you get onto the island, during this time, there were endangered species. And so transportation and access to the site were quite difficult.
This area was hit particularly hard, and we had a pretty significant staining of oil on the beaches, about anywhere from 3 to 8 feet wide, probably about an inch thick in some spots.
We do what they call shoreline cleanup and assessment. We walk up and down the beaches, and we look for oil, assessing to see if any of that oil had actually been covered up and to see if there was any remnant of oil underneath the surface.
And it was pretty emotional seeing a lot of the oiled birds that we were collecting.
When we had captured a live oiled loon, and we were putting the loon in the cage, and it gave its little cry, that was something that really got to me. That's going to be one thing I remember about that spill, that cry of that bird.
My role was to track the expenditures, make sure we had them documented, and submitted that to the Coast Guard for reimbursement.
It's a lot of work, it's a lot of overtime, it's a lot of hours, but we all work together and work for the better.
The cleanup crew did a good job of cleaning everything up. They did it in a quick manner. I've seen how resilient our coastline is. Since then, the beach has really recovered.
They are very, very special.
One, two,
basically gave up just about everything they had in their personal life for almost a month just to be out there to help protect the resources of the state of Texas.